Good morning, students. Let us continue module 5. In this lecture video, we will be discussing two topics. One is operating systems on Raspberry Pi, and second is programming Raspberry Pi with Python. As you know that Raspberry Pi is a small computer, so definitely operating system must be running on Raspberry Pi. Any computer to function, any computer operating system requires. So what all operating systems can be used, or what all the operating systems can be supported by Raspberry Pi computer system? So let us go. You have a few options when it comes to interacting with Raspberry Pi. The first and most common is to use it like you would a full desktop computer. We can use the Raspberry Pi like a full desktop computer. This involves connecting a keyboard, mouse and monitor. For this, separately we can connect a keyboard, mouse and monitor with the Raspberry Pi, and the full computer will become ready. What this setup? You are likely best served by installing Raspbian with desktop. We can install Raspbian operating system with desktop, which gives you a full graphical user interface to work with. So this Raspbian, it will give us a full graphical user interface to work with. So Raspbian is an operating system which will work like a desktop operating system. This is the best option if you want an experience similar to working with other operating systems such as Windows, Mac OS or other popular Linux flavor like Ubuntu. So this Raspbian, it works like Windows, Mac OS and Linux flavor Ubuntu with Raspberry Pi. Now let us see. So first we saw that Raspbian, it is like several operating system which can be executed, which can run on Raspbian Pi computer system. Raspbian is a Debian based engineered especially for Raspberry Pi, and it is the perfect general purpose operating system for Raspberry Pi. So Raspbian operating system, it is a purpose general purpose operating system for Raspberry Pi computer system. Second operating system is OSMC, Open Source Media Center. It is a free, simple, open source and easy to use standalone OD operating system capable of playing virtually any media format. So this operating system, it is used first of all, it is open source, it is simple and it is free, and it is easy to use stand alone virtually any media format can run. Then OpenElect, it means Open Embedded Linux Entertainment Center. It is a small Linux based JEOS, just enough operating system developed from scratch to run PCs into a Kodi Media Center. It is like a small Linux based operating system. It is developed from scratch to run personal computers into a Kodi Media Center. Fourth operating system which can run on Raspberry Pi is RISC operating system. It is a unique open source operating system used especially for ARM processor by the creator of the original ARM. It is used for ARM processor and it is neither related to Linux nor Windows and is being maintained by a dedicated community of volunteers. So this operating system, it is maintained by a community of volunteers. It is neither Linux based nor Windows based. Fifth type of operating system which can be executed, it can run on Raspberry Pi, is Windows IoT Core. It is a Windows operating system built specially for the Raspberry Pi as a development platform for programmers and coders. Those user who wants to do programming or coding, in Raspberry Pi. For them, they can use Windows IoT Core operating system. Its aim is for programmers to use it to build prototypes of IoT devices using the Raspberry Pi and Windows 10. Its aim is to create a IoT prototype devices, IoT supported devices prototype using the Raspberry Pi and Windows 10 operating system. So these are the few operating systems which I have explained. Apart from this, so many around 20-25 operating system currently which can run on Raspberry Pi. Then programming Raspberry Pi with Python. Okay, so in the Raspberry Pi computer system, we can write a Python program and we can run it. We can make the hardware function using the Python program. The Raspberry Pi is an amazing single board computer capable of running Linux and a whole host of applications. It is capable of running a whole host of applications. It is a single board computer like a smart card, and it can run a lot of applications. Python. So Python is a beginner friendly programming language that is used in schools, web development, scientific research, and in many other industries. So Python, it is a, as like a C, the basic programming language, very easy to learn. Similarly, Python is also very easy and it is a beginner friendly programming language. Nowadays, we are teaching Python even in school also. It is used for web development, scientific research, and in many other industries. Python is a wonderful and powerful programming language that is easy to use, I mean easy to read and easy to write, and with Raspberry Pi lets you connect your project to the real world. And if we use the Python in Raspberry Pi, so if this programming language let us connect ourselves with a project, using the project with the real world. So let us see the basic of Python, how it will be written. Suppose you want to print, you want to display a hello world, so you can simply write print hello world. Then suppose you want to print hello 10 times, then you can use this for I in range 10 colon and print hello. So like this, this I will run 10 times and this hello it will be displaying 10 times. Third type of code is for I in range 2 colon print A print B. So what it will print first, it will print A then B then again A and then B. It will it is a loop. Fourth type of program for I in range 2 print A and print B. You can see that here the space is there for print A. Means print A it is a part of this for loop, but print B it is just starting from where the for loop it is starting. The same, no indentation. Then print A will it means print A is only there under this for loop. Print B is not there for the for loop. So A 2 times and B. Then variables, it is used to save a value to a variable, assign it like so. The different variables can be used to assign the value like name equal to Bob, age equal to 15. So this is another type of variable used. So like that only, so many basic concepts are there for Python, and Python it is fully supported for the Raspberry Pi computer. So we'll finish it up till here only. In the next lecture video, we will be seeing wireless temperature monitoring system using Pi. Thank you very much.